Hello, welcome back to another video. My name is Mike Davies, and in today's tutorial, I'll be showing you how to resize an image inside of GIMP. I'll be using GIMP version 2.10.24, which is the latest version of GIMP at the time of this tutorial. So let's cut to the chase here. To scale an image, you're gonna go to Image, Scale Image. And this is gonna bring up the scale image dialog. You'll see this image is pretty large. And if I wanted to scale this, all I have to do is type the new width I want for this. So for example, 1920. And right now you'll see over here, there's a little chain link icon. If this is not locked, so you'll see here that the little icon here is unlinked, then this is not going to keep the original aspect ratio and you'll end up with one of those squished looking images or distorted images. However, if this is locked, that means the aspect ratio will be maintained. So in this case, when I started out, this was locked, which means when I type 1920 here, if I simply hit the tab key, this will automatically update the height to match the original aspect ratio of the image. And right now this is set to pixels. You can also change this to any unit that you want. You'll see there are a variety of units there, but I'll keep this set to pixels. The X and Y resolution are gonna have to do with printing. So if you're saving this for the web, you can pretty much ignore this. Otherwise, if you are saving this for print, if you want a high quality print, you typically go with 300 to 400 pixels per inch. And once again, the little chain link icon is going to apply here. So if I hit the tab key, that will automatically update the Y resolution. Typically, both of these are gonna be the exact same value. And as per usual, you have other units of measurement here if you want to change this to something different. But again, this is not really going to apply if you are saving for the web. Finally, the interpolation quality I'll get into in a second here, but because I am scaling this down greater than 50% of the original size, I would go with low halo here. And once I'm ready, I can hit scale. That's how you resize an image in GIMP. Before I dive into the next part of this video, don't forget to check out my website at daviesmediadesign.com. As always, I have tons of video tutorials on here, as well as free software help articles, so definitely check that out. You can get more by becoming a DMD Premium member, and you can enroll in my GIMP 2.10 Masterclass from Beginner to Pro Photo Editing on Udemy, and I'll include a link to this, as well as all the relevant links from this tutorial in the description of the video. All right, so that's pretty much the basics, but there is a lot that goes into scaling an image in GIMP in terms of selecting the best interpolation method. And there's also some advice I wanna give in terms of scaling when it comes to scaling large images. So let me start with that. When you're scaling a huge image, I do recommend saving your work first because GIMP does tend to stall out, especially as you get deeper into a session in GIMP. So let's say you're designing a composition, you've done tons of steps, and you decide you want to scale that image down. Well, I do recommend saving the work first because GIMP can stall out. Let me hit Control Z here to back up. And let me also go to Image, Scale Image. So there's also the quality here, and I do have an entire tutorial covering how to scale an image with minimal quality loss. You're always gonna lose quality when you're scaling an image, whether you're scaling up or down. That's because pixels are either having to be taken out of your original image or added to the original image. So anytime you are messing with the original data of an image, it's going to lose quality. But basically the spark notes of interpolation is that anytime you are scaling your image up, I recommend going with no halo for the interpolation quality. Anytime you are scaling your image down by less than 50%, so you are keeping the image above half the original size, in that case, I also recommend no halo. And if you're trying to preserve skin tones and you also don't have any sort of pixel art or text in your image, keep it at no halo. On the other hand, if you are scaling your image down by less than 50%, so meaning you're gonna scale the image to be less than half its original size, you're gonna wanna go with low halo. Also, if your image contains pixel art or text, you're gonna wanna go with low halo. And finally, if you are scaling your image down and you also have your skin tones you're trying to preserve, but you also have your text, I recommend using low halo first. And if you're not happy with the way the colors look when you scale it down, undo that scaling and then just redo the scaling with no halo. So basically just try out which is gonna work better with your image. And finally, if you have a lot of artifacts in your image, so if the quality of the image itself is not great, then I do recommend going with low halo as well. So if you're using a slower computer, then you're gonna wanna actually go with a different interpolation method such as cubic or linear, just because low halo and no halo are gonna be pretty resource intensive options. But if your computer can handle those resource intensive operations, then I recommend going with no halo or low halo. So let's go through a couple of examples here. This is a pretty large image and there's not gonna be any pixel art or text in here. So in the beginning, I went with 1920, but let's say we went with something different. So let's say we went with 4000 as the width, and I'll hit the tab key. In this case, we could probably go with no halo because we're scaling this so that the final image is gonna be greater than 50% the original size. So I'll come over here and hit scale. So there's the result of that. Now let's come over here to a different example. So here you'll see I have a black and white photo, so there's not gonna be skin tones in here. We also have text in here and pixel art because we've got this little text box. So to scale this, I would go to image, scale image. And this image isn't that large, but I'm still gonna come over here and change this to low halo. And let's say we wanted to scale the height down to 1000. Hit the tab key. Because the little chain link icon is locked here, it'll automatically update the width. And I'll come over here and hit scale. And there you can see the result of that. One thing I want to point out is when you're using the image scale image option, even if you have multiple layers here, as you see I have, it will scale all of those layers automatically. If you have text layers like I had, the text layers are basically going to have the text information discarded, and the text layers will then become regular layers. You can still edit this text if I scroll in. So I'll grab my text tool. If I click on here, it'll ask me if I want to convert this back to a text layer. So if I hit edit, it'll convert that back to the text layer. But as you can see, the text is back to its original size before the scaling. So keep that in mind. I'll hit Control Z to back up. On the other hand, if I come over here and scale this image, everything is going to be on a single layer. So none of that stuff that I just mentioned will be a problem. Let's do one more example where we scale this image that has the text and pixel art up. So let's start by going to image, scale image, and in this case, which interpolation we're gonna use isn't exactly black and white to use a pun here. But because we have text and pixel art, you probably would wanna go with low halo, but also because we're gonna scale this up, you might wanna try no halo first and see if that looks better. So let's come over here and let's up this to 4500, hit the tab key, and come over here and hit scale. And we're gonna get a warning here that this is gonna create a fairly significantly large image, so I'll hit scale. So as you can see, the final result of that actually looks pretty good. So low halo did work there. Let me hit Control Z, and we can go image, scale image. Let's go 4500 again. And this time we'll try low halo, hit scale. Again, we get that message. I'll hit scale anyway. Hold Control, zoom in. In this case, it looks pretty good as well. So one thing I want to point out is that the differences between low halo and no halo are pretty minor. So really, if you go with either one, you can't go wrong. The only times you're going to notice a huge difference are if you go with the faster options, which is going to be linear or cubic. And I think just to oversimplify everything I've talked about here, if you're going to scale up, it's probably good to go with no halo. If you're going to scale down, it's good to go with low halo. All right, so that's it for this tutorial. Hopefully you liked it. If you did, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to be notified each time I have a brand new tutorial. You can check out any of the links to my resources in the description of the video. But thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.